Well, Brian Clough has got a worry for them, Brian Hamilton. So it's almost edging 2-1 against Northern Ireland, which I must say surprises me. I would have thought that your lads might have been clear favourites tonight.
Well, I feel that the passion that the Irish have for the game and the desire they have to do well in this competition, and I think they, as I've said, look as if they're enjoying the whole competition. And I'm very confident and I expect it to win me a couple of clear goals.
I hope so, young man.
Thank you, sir.
Well, it's certainly the start of a very important time for Britain in this World Cup, with England playing later on tonight, and the team was announced last night, and Scotland playing tomorrow night against Denmark, which is another live game on our channel of the Irish lads. There, it certainly looks as though it's another really hot occasion here in Guadalajara. It was 96 degrees the other afternoon. Of course, it's lunchtime. It's midday there in Guadalajara at the moment in Mexico. And the Algerians, Bruce, I suppose, would have a much better idea of how to adapt themselves to this sort of heat, wouldn't they?
That's correct. They play right up in the north of Africa, where these temperatures soar to 90 degrees in the winter. So they'll be very used to it.
In the winter?
That's in the winter, yes.
In 90 degrees in the winter? Degrees,
yeah.
Now, that's not bad. It gives them a fair start.
Now, just looking at that, Brian, yeah. I think one of the most important positions in the whole competition is going to be the goalkeeping position.
Well, I was just going to talk correct. About it. And 41 years old.
Well, I mean, people have their own ideas and the best in the world, and I've played with him and played against him, and I just think he's an incredible man, and I think he'll play a massive part in the Irish campaign this year.
Well, let's get another goalkeeper's view then of Pat Jennings. Bruce?
No, Pat is a marvellous example to any youngster who wanted to take up the sport. He's very dedicated, he works hard at his game, and he just loves playing, I think.
I think he's an example to anybody, anywhere, anytime.
That's right.
Sport doesn't come into it. We're just lucky to have him in our industry.
Well, the Algerian team caption coming up there, missing Rachid Harkouk, who we thought might well be playing, the Notts County man.
Why is he not playing, Brian? Is he injured?
No, I don't think he's injured. He's played three times for them, but he's obviously not been included on this occasion. And there we have the Northern Ireland team with the smiling Pat. And now, for the first time, you're looking at the complete rundown here. Jimmy Nicol, who'd had a little bit of trouble with injury, is fit to take the number two shirt. Mal Donaghy of Luton Town in the number three shirt, such a tremendous competitor. O'Neill, one of your lads from Leicester City, isn't he? MacDonald, big Alan MacDonald from Queen's Park Rangers. Little David McCreary, such a dynamo in the midfield. Now Penny, the right back from Brighton. Sammy McElroy, the skipper. And big Norman at, wearing the number 10 shirt. Nigel Worthington from Sheffield Wednesday. And Billy Hamilton, who had such a terrible run with injuries. And it's good to see that the Oxford United lad has overcome those and now can get into the action.
Looking at that side, there's an awful lot of players in the team who can do a lot of work. McCreary, McElroy, Worthington, they can do a lot of legwork, and I think that that'll be an important asset tonight. I think you look at the two strikers, I'm a bit surprised to see Norman playing up there, but I can understand that he's strong, he knows the position, he can hold the ball up, and I think him and Billy Hamilton will create a lot of problems for the...
Yes, indeed. The Russian referee we've just seen go through. Yes, indeed. And they will take a lot of heart from the fact that nobody gave them a great deal of chance in Spain, and they delighted and surprised a lot of people out there, of course.
Well, the one thing about us, Bran, we've always played with this great passion. We've always been short, as Bran has said quite rightly. We lack in certain skill factors and maybe the quality players, but the passion, the desire, the ambition, and every one of those lads playing tonight are playing for everybody back in Northern Ireland.
We'll run at them like we do, obviously, but I'm not sure if we can run at them for 90 minutes.
Right.
That is the telling question, of course.
Like I say, Brian, I think it's important that these fellas, like I say, when you see Al MacDonald after the England game, he was talking about his brothers and his mother and his father, and I know exactly how they feel, because that's every match I played, I felt that way. You're representing people back home.
Yes.
And I'm sure everyone will be doing that.
There's our subs coming up. I'm sorry and disappointed young Campbell's not
David Campbell of Nottingham Forest.
He can play anywhere.
Good player.
Play right back, midfield, up front, and he's a good sub.
And he's a good motor as well, Brian, hasn't he? He can work as well.
Well, we think he is, but I'm a little bit biased.
No, I think you're right.
I'm not biased in giving an opinion.
No, I think you're dead.
If he couldn't play, I'd tell you.
Oh, no, he's a good runner, he can work hard, and he's done well.
I'm surprised he's not on, particularly on his 21st.
Is it his 21st?
Aye.
Oh, dear.
He'll never get to 22 unless he looks up when to play a ball.
The big man looks very calm, Brian, doesn't he?
Well, he always does.
Yeah, he's very much in control of the whole situation.
All right, let's go across then to Guadalajara. I gather Peter Brackley is already underway with his commentary. Let's see if we can join him. Ron Atkinson is with him.
This is one today to qualify for the... Well, Ron Atkinson, sitting up on top of me here. What about the conditions out there? What about the problems the players are going to face? The crowd here at the stadium today would have been around. The Jalisco Stadium, but there's still quite a feeling about this one here, Ron. A word on the Irish selection, in particular the choice at the back of McDonald in preference to McClellan.
As you are well aware, you don't need me to tell you, I'm sure, we again, as we had, was it on Sunday night, terrible problems with our sound out of Guadalajara. Peter Brackley was the unfortunate commentator that night for Brazil and Spain, who didn't get a word uttered the whole of the 90 minutes, along with many, many commentators right through the world of television. And as you know, there were enormous repercussions between the European Broadcasting Union and FIFA over this, and it seems the problems are continuing. The Mexicans at the moment just seem unable to cope with the huge demands that are putting upon their communications. So, while the Russian referee looks to get the game started, at least it shouldn't spoil too much your enjoyment of it, I hope, because we can see that the Northern Ireland lads in the white shirts and green shorts are raring to go, and they'll be attacking the goal.
What do you think about Guadalajara just at the moment? So away then go Northern Ireland. There's first ever international between the two nations. And Northern Ireland have certainly come here in good fettle, unbeaten in their last eight internationals. Indeed, the last time they were beaten was by England in Belfast, and that was as long ago as 15 months ago. Majadi, Majer, who will certainly be an important player for Algeria today. Majer, one of their overseas stars. It goes Donaghy now then for Northern Ireland.
In your mouth, please.
Tackle from Majadi.
You have to put your McDonald near.
It'll
your
be interesting,
mouth.
Ron, to see what formation the Algerians do use. It looks as if they're going to play with just two up front. Whiteside, good turn. The first shot of the game, rather ambitious perhaps, but Norman Whiteside showing confidence early on, and I think the Irish cap, Ron, will be most relieved that Norman is in the side. The Algerians, incidentally, have made a surprise in goal. El Labi has been chosen, contrary to reports that we've had throughout the week, Madrid would be their first choice goalkeeper, but they've made quite a few late changes at the last moment. And they've obviously got to compensate for the loss of Belloumi, one of their star players in midfield. This is John O'Neill. Long ball in search of Hamilton, who couldn't outjump there. Majadi. Alabi, who was certainly, we were told anyway, was the second choice goalkeeper. He's been referred today to Azredine Dried. Now this is Maroc for Algeria, one of their midfield players. Kathy Saeed, a player who's greatly impressed Billy Bingham. Matches that he's seen of Algeria, he saw their match in Switzerland recently. And Kathy Saeed is a player he's wanted us to watch out for. This is Assad, one of the survivors from 82. He scored a couple of goals in their 3-2 win over Chile. Good tackle though by Donaghy. Plenty of support here for Northern Ireland in Guadalajara. Northern Ireland fans arriving in the last few days. I think they can be sure of a good following here. Ferrucci, the defender who came across. Worthington with the throw, and here now that is done.
Independent TV London Britain.
Esta es la.
Sammy McElroy. McElroy and McCreary, the two players at the heart of the midfield for Northern Ireland today. Kenny and Worthington wide off the flanks. Looking to Kenny for some early crosses. He's the head of right side in Hamilton. McDonald, the revelation he's been since coming into the Northern Ireland side, and his form has been such. Billy Bingham has kept it in today. Rather than bring back McClellan. Oh, into the area there.
In from that free kick, it definitely took a deflection, but a really dream start for Billy Bingham's side, and you can see the looks of joy on the faces of the Irish players, Sammy McElroy and Norman Whiteside. And there the ball, it did cannon in off an Algerian defender. Norman Whiteside though takes the credit.
Yes, squished up from Northern Ireland, John, it's the ball straight through the middle of the lineup there, bad lineup, but nonetheless, what's Algeria's misfortune is Northern Ireland's good fortune. It's a lovely start for them.
Well, Norman Whiteside scored three goals in the qualifying rounds, but that is perhaps the most crucial goal he's ever scored for his country. And of course, one has to remember, Billy, that Norman Whiteside 4 years ago was the youngest man ever to play in World Cup finals.
Yes, it's astonishing to think that he's still only 21, and here he is, almost a veteran, as it were, of so many games for Manchester United. And indeed, this is his second World Cup. Tremendous record for a young player.
It's going to be interesting now to see how Algeria react to that early setback. That's an experience, although of course they did play in Spain 4 years ago. And how nice to see Pat Jennings here. Pat Jennings, who will be 41 in 9 days' time. And how marvellous to think that he's virtually been out of the Football League all season. And here he is playing in a World Cup finals. His 117th cap. That's an international record for a goalkeeper. Now the Algerians making those late changes, and it's obviously a blow to them that Lakhdar Belloumi, a former African Footballer of the Year, is not starting the game. He is on the substitutes bench. And one or two surprises in the selection made by Rabah Sadani, their manager.
But for now, all eyes are on Maldonaghy. And the Irish, a goal to the good. Jimmy Nicol out on the right-hand touchline. Keen to impress in this World Cup, as he's been told that West Bromwich Albion will perhaps no longer require his services next season. Donaghy with the throw. And here's Sammy McIlroy, well known to my co-commentator here, Billy McNeil. He's his manager, of course, at Manchester City. This time the Algerian defence is equal to it. There's some very experienced players in their defence. When you look at the number of caps that some of them have won, Mahmoud Gouindous, for example, 119 caps. Karichi has won 46 caps. And Cassie Said in midfield has a total of 86 caps. So you can see that there are some very experienced players in the Algerian side. But there has been this surprise selection by their manager. Good pace there from Majer. Oh, what an extraordinary that. The ball bouncing very high indeed, and almost causing a problem for El Hadi Labi. Now, Cassie Said. Northern Ireland really couldn't have asked for a better start than that. The surprise team in many ways in Spain 4 years ago, of course, when they beat Spain to go through the first round matches. And here they are, a goal up against Algeria. So it seems to me, Billy, that the World Cup brings the best out of the Irish.
It most certainly does, John. To be honest with you, they're a very experienced side, and they continue to come up with incredible results. You look through the qualifying section, it looked as though it was all lost to Northern Ireland, but they came through when few people expected them to.
But for the moment, it's Algeria in possession with Fawzi Mansouri. And McDonald, and now McIlroy for Northern Ireland, bundle off the ball, and that will be a free kick awarded by Mr. Valery Buchenko, the Soviet Union official. His two linesmen today, Andrei Dana from Switzerland and Zoran Petrovic from Yugoslavia. 10 minutes gone, Northern Ireland 1, Algeria 0 here in Guadalajara. There's a promising little move there involving Sammy McIlroy. Algeria looking to come into Irish territory. This is Abdallah Ajadi, who plays for Monaco, France. And the crowd sensing there that there was going to be a free kick to Algeria, giving some of the Irish players a little bit of the Irish here won't mind too much about that. A goal in the lead. Norman Whiteside. Ajadi with a free kick floated in and away by David McCreary, of all people, popping up there. Right side, well, doing the sensible thing in the end. There weren't many options open to him then. But really, they couldn't have asked for a more encouraging start than this.
No, it's a lovely start for them, John. Obviously, one of the problems in the World Cup, when you're playing nations like Algeria, although we don't reckon very much of them, we've seen yesterday with Morocco's performance against Poland, their forces. And I think you can't afford to do it casually. Northern Ireland have got exactly the start they wanted. They've got a good composed side. They'll hold on to the lead, I'm quite sure of that.
And the searing heat of Guadalajara means that everybody in the stadium here is in their shirt sleeves. And the Irish supporters who've travelled, it's amazing to me how they managed to do it, but there are around about 500 or 600 of them here, and they're making their presence well felt. And they certainly have plenty to sing about at the moment. Maroc. And Maroc involved again. Nice little bit of interplay there with Majer, who started out on the right-hand side, but it's all going to come to nothing. That ball is played back to Pat Jennings. A free kick has been given. Just picking himself up is Cassie Saeed, who made his international debut in 1980 but missed out in Spain. He didn't win selection then, but he has been just about a fixture in the side ever since. So the Irish having to defend here with Algeria, given their turn to see what they can do from a free kick. Remember, the Irish took their lead from a Norman Whiteside free kick, which was certainly better orchestrated than that one by Algeria. And a rather lazy ball forward there, causing no problems whatsoever for the Irish defence. And obviously they'll be able to slow the game down, but bearing in mind the result in the previous game in the group, in which Brazil beat Spain, the Northern Ireland boys will be very happy at the moment. I think many people see this as the game which might well provide a third team going through to the last 16, and Northern Ireland having that early advantage. Be absolutely delighted. Billy Hamilton going up there. Can't get the touch, but Sammy McElroy will keep the ball in play. And, inside the area was Stephen Penny, and the Irish have a corner. The corner taken here by Penny, so a chance for Ireland to get a second. Maybe the ball came right across the area and it's missed off the line. The first header came in from Billy Hamilton, cleared off the line, but that was a great opportunity for Northern Ireland to go two ahead. 15 minutes gone, but they're in the lead.
Yes, a tremendous performance so far, John. Northern Ireland have obviously enhanced with the confidence of that first goal, and they're not going to give up, is it? They've got tremendous presence of height and inside the opponent's box, and I would think at set pieces and corner kicks they could be very dangerous.
And if people back home are wondering why they're hearing my voice and why coverage is rather different to what they would normally expect, we do have problems at the moment with the line from Guadalajara, and I'm sitting in a studio in Mexico City, and we're trying to bring you the best coverage possible while looking at the pictures from Guadalajara, but we have no sound from the stadium there at the moment. So Algeria now moving inside the Irish half. This is Salah Assad. And Assad has gone to take that return ball, and I think he's just about kept it in play, but now he's knocked it out, and that should be a goal kick. Indeed it is. So a good long goal kick from Pat Jennings there. Whiteside going up, but the whistle already gone, as I'm sure you heard that. We're hearing all sorts of noises, I can tell you, at the moment. But let's not worry about that. This is Cassie Saeed on the ball for Algeria. A goal down. Algeria, by the way, the first African nation ever to qualify for successive World Cup finals. I surprised a lot of people in Spain 4 years ago
particularly, of course, when they defeated West Germany. And there was tremendous sympathy for them when they went out, when the Germans and the Austrians managed to contrive a result which saw them both through to the next round. And Billy Bingham has just about been able to select from his entire squad. Jimmy Quinn has had a foot injury, tendon trouble, a chance for a second, white side! So close, Billy Hamilton just nudging the ball through to him. Billy McNeil, the manager of Manchester City, sitting with me. Norman Whiteside has got one, he might well have got another.
Well, that's right, that could have been the second goal for Northern Ireland. Lovely start to them, you know, the thoughts crossed my mind that Billy Hamilton up front with Norman Whiteside, he's going to cause, those two are going to cause an awful lot of problems to that Algerian back four, however experienced they might be, John.
And it is encouraging that the Irish have created those opportunities in these early stages of the game. So many of the World Cup matches so far have been tight and defensive. And the other thing that has to be said at the moment, I think, is that the Irish seem to have adapted pretty well to the conditions.
Yes, it's lovely sitting here in the studio looking at all that good weather. We feel we're entitled to some of it here in Mexico City, John, but well, the Irish, because they've acclimatised well, they've got the benefit of the early goal, they're a very experienced side, they don't give up either, and they've produced some astonishing results. It looks like this might be another one.
Yes, Mexico is a strange old place. While the sun beats down in Guadalajara, there's plenty of rain in Mexico City. And certainly Algeria should find these conditions very much to their liking. And a free kick given once more against Billy Hamilton. And it's so good to see Billy Hamilton back in action. He virtually missed the entire Football League season last year, scored just two goals, one right at the start and one right at the finish, and otherwise it was a wasted season for him because of that terrible injury he had. And in fact, this is Billy Hamilton's first cap since 1984, when he played against Spain. But such an important player to the Irish with his physical presence. And of course, he was one of the stars of their campaign in Spain 4 years ago. That's nice play. Oh, that's brilliant play, in fact. And Assad taking the return. Real danger here for the Irish. And what good covering by Alan McDonald, the Queen's Park Rangers centre-back, getting across there. And he's certainly made a good start to his international career.
He's been a real find for the Irish. He's had a tremendous season at QPR, and at international level he's acclimatised very, very well indeed.
But Algeria have a corner, left-footed, and it flew beyond everybody. And one of the problems out here in Mexico has been judging the pace of the ball. Again, it's drifted back inside the area. They're not a very tall side, the Algerians, though. Apart from a certain defender who is 6'3", that's Kurici. This is Majer, good, skillful player, Rabah Majer. He plays for FC Porto. And that's going to be safe enough for Northern Ireland. The one thing, though, they mustn't, they must beware of one or two of these Algerian front players, especially Majer, who's very experienced.
Well, that's right. We saw a nice little interchange, and all of a sudden Assad was tearing down into that Irish box. They're typical of what we've seen of the African nations. They play a lot of 1-2s, nice quick players. It's important that Northern Ireland don't relax at all.
Well, Pat Jennings has lost nothing with his right boot. Good long kick from him. But again, the Russian referee blows his whistle. And there's going to be a free kick to the Algerian side, which has already been taken. Majer asking his defender, Mejadi, to take things up a little bit further.
Najadi, by the way, preferred here to the regular right-back, Sadmi. As we mentioned earlier, there have been one or two surprises in the Algerian selection. They've been playing behind closed doors for most of the time here in Mexico. And they've not had good results in the build-up matches either. So the feeling is that they might not be as strong as they were in Germany 4 years ago, in Spain 4 years ago. Again, they're building from the back. This time with Cassie Sain, who's very strong on the ball. He's certainly impressed Billy Bingham. Good little ball through as well here for Zidane, and the cross coming in, and that was a nice move by the Algerians, and it all stemmed from the pace of Cassie Sain.
This is a thing the Irish are going to have to watch. They look as the Algerians look as though they've got some very quick players up front. Nice little interchange here, nice little 1-2, and all of a sudden they're in behind. Very dangerous situation. Well tidied up, well cleared up. I think it was Maldonado that cleared that one up.
But, certainly did well to get back.
Timely interception.
The Algerian player who stretched out there is Majer, who used to play for the Racing Club of Paris before his move to FC Porto. He's winning his 86th cap today. My bet is he'll be back on his feet in a moment or two. And as you can see, the Irish do have a player laid out as well. There has been a rule introduced here. It is indeed Maldonado. That stretchers should be brought on to get players off the pitch as quickly as possible, even if they're not badly injured. But that's not happening here. There does seem to be some concern in the Algerian ranks about Majer. I'll tell you one person who'll be a little bit disturbed, and that is his sister, who's a television announcer in Algeria. I wonder if she's working today. Maldonado has obviously got a cut on the head and is leaving the pitch.
Yes, I think it's been an obvious clash of heads, and you can see the blood on the picture there, so it looks quite a nasty one.
And Guindouz there is acting as masseur as well, I think, and baggage man. And a little bit of consternation down on the bench. At the end of all this, Algeria will have a corner, but with Maldonado off the pitch, an anxious moment. So there you see a very good close-up really of what happened. Obvious clash of heads between Majer and Maldonado. Who's the most accomplished defender. Billy Bingham calls him the Rolls Royce of the Northern Ireland side. And you can see that Majer is in some discomfort as well. The corner is taken, flat, low and miskicked by Curici. So I wonder who'll miss a player the most. And I wonder too whether we'll have any substitutions.
Well, looking at things, Ireland are obviously having a player or two limber up on the bench there, John. I think they'll hold off. It looks like a cut in the head, but there he is coming back on there.
Yes, there was just a brief shot of Paul Ramsey, the Leicester City fullback, who would have been the obvious deputy for Maldonado. But anyway, Donaghy is back in the action. And straight away involved in the play. And Rashid Harkouk, I can tell you, is limbering up on the touchline as well. So perhaps Algeria are going to introduce the Notts County man in place of Majer. And safely worked back to El Labi this time. This is Majadi. Cassie Said. And a reminder that Northern Ireland are leading here in Guadalajara by a goal to nil. An early strike by Norman Whiteside, who's been playing up front alongside Billy Hamilton. The free kick, which was deflected off the Algerian wall, and it was just the tonic that Northern Ireland wanted. These two countries have never met previously. And Algeria's recent results have been disappointing. They've been beaten by the Cameroons and by Switzerland in warm-up games before coming here.
and they favour the slow clinical approach at the moment, but Assad can break quickly, surrounded by white shirts. There has just been the odd occasion where the Irish defence has looked in a spot of bother against the pace of the Algerians up front. But against Northern Ireland themselves have created a couple of good chances. Still no sign of whether Majer is coming back on the pitch or whether Harkouk is to replace him. Ben Mabrouk. And now Guindouz, who's actually won 119 caps for his country. Well, that is what they call experience. And talking of that, there's Pat Jennings. You probably just caught a sight of the crowd there. We've got this marvellously spectacular rhythm going. They all leap up in the air, a section of the stand at a time. Think about it, the Mexicans do enjoy their football. Donaghy. He doesn't appear to be too affected by that cut on the head. Nicely done, Sammy McIlroy. He finds Whiteside on that left touchline. Was a little bit behind Stephen Penny, but he's done well to retrieve the ball. Lost it now though. And Billy McNeil, it seems to me that Billy Bingham has packed his midfield.
Well, they're good at packing the defence, just that they've had some good results. Very good defensively, John. At the moment, they've lost just a little bit of touch in midfield. The Algerians have just got a little bit of control there, and with those quick lads up front, it just could cause a little bit of a problem.
And it looks as though Rashid Harkouk is about to enter the fray. We saw him just standing on the touchline. So Majer is not going to return to the game. That's a bit of a blow for Algeria. Here they are now with Cassie Saïd. Very elegant on the ball. Trying to work things away down that left-hand side. Assad eventually plays the ball there, but they're having to come back inside with Cassie Saïd again. Half an hour gone. Algeria 0, Northern Ireland 1 in Guadalajara. The other match already played in this group, of course. Brazil beat Spain in those controversial circumstances by a goal to nil. Things then looking good for Northern Ireland at the moment. This is Assad. Quite content just to play the ball around and wait for an opening. The shot charged down and eventually rolled back to Pat Jennings. It really is astonishing to think, Billy, that Pat Jennings made his Northern Ireland debut in 1964 in the same match that George Best made his debut.
It's lovely to think of Pat still playing. It's a lovely accolade to him and his attitude to his profession. He's kept himself in good order and you can see the benefit of it.
Hamilton, just slipping around a little bit there. The ball eventually worked back. It was Nigel Worthington who played it inside to Donaghy. And nicely away by the big man in defence, Curici, all 6'3" of him. Here's McDonald, who looks very composed. Alan McDonald made a very good debut against Romania last year and, of course, scored against Denmark recently. And it's nice to see Nigel Worthington playing because he had a very, very bad leg injury. And he missed the end of the season with Sheffield Wednesday. Do you feel you can hear a little bit of applause and cheering in the background? Although you're not seeing the picture, that is because
well.
Majer is being led away to the comfort of the dressing room, which will give Rashid Harkouk the opportunity to come onto the pitch. There is Majer. Shame to see a player of that stature go off, but nice to see a player of this stature come on. And he's certainly one player who'll know plenty about the Irish, and especially, of course, about Nigel Worthington. They used to play together at Notts County.
Yes, it's astonishing to think that an Englishman first come up for Algeria in the World Cup. On his day, he can be a very useful player. Let's hope for Northern Ireland's sake it's not his day.
Well, it's not Algeria's day at the moment. That is Cassie Said, who is down on the ground. Although it says Carici there, they're having one or two problems at the moment. McIlroy. Trying to work things out with David McCreary. The free kick again going against Algeria. And I think a little bit of a complaint going on from Abdelhamid Ben Mabrouk. That one really rolls off the tongue, doesn't it? Well, Northern Ireland have already scored from one free kick. El Hadi Labi is only too aware of that. This time, though, they've played the ball wide to the right to Stephen Penny. And no danger this time. Well, this is quite astonishing, the number of stoppages due to injuries. And this time, the man down on the ground is Mansouri. I don't think that's quite Paul Ramsey. Not only is the colour of the shirt different, the country is different. That is definitely Mansouri, the man who is down. So with one man already off, one man lying prostrate, these are not happy days for Algeria.
No, it's difficult times for them. Northern Ireland have started the game well, John. They've got the benefit of that early goal and they've looked confident. Only once have we really seen Algeria get behind them. Other than that, Northern Ireland seem very composed, look calm in their approach in midfield, and they look very, very determined at the back.
So important, of course, for every country to win its first game in the World Cup.
I think in this particular section it is. Having seen Brazil win the first game, it was very important for Northern Ireland to win this one. But it is very important for Northern Ireland to win this.
The referee is reaching for his yellow card. And he's also not too pleased, I don't think, about the way some of the Algerians are protesting. And it looks to me as though it's Mansouri who has been booked. He was the player who went down in that challenge, and he's been booked as well for his pains. So a booking for Fawzi Mansouri, another of those experienced Algerian players. He was brought back into the international side recently. We don't seem to have such long delays whenever free kicks are awarded, one way or another. And the Soviet referee is going to have to take a pretty firm grip on this match, Mr. Butchenko. So let's see what Northern Ireland can do here. They lead 1-0. The second goal before half-time would do very nicely, thank you. Labi trying to organise that wall in front of him, and Norman Whiteside might well take another crack, and this time it does come cannoning back off the wall. As you see, plenty of time for John O'Neill to pick out a colleague. Unfortunately, when he did so, that man was offside.
Yes, you know, when you look at those front two players for Northern Ireland, it really is a fearsome sight. And Northern Ireland, they've got this young lad Steve Penny, who can go down that wing. If he can get down there, throw in a few crosses, I'm quite sure Billy Hamilton and Norman Whiteside are going to really test this defence.
Were you surprised that Norman Whiteside was asked to play up front for me?
No, I think Norman's such an adaptable player, and he can play well there. He's played long enough there and been a very, very good centre forward.
Still only 21 years of age as well. There's another young man with a big future ahead of him, Alan McDonald, the Queen's Park Rangers. I think it would be fair to say that this could well be Pat Jennings' last World Cup. It's remarkable that here he is at the age of 40, almost 41. And of course, the World Cup has a history of great goalkeepers who carried on until they were certainly veterans. Dino Zoff, one remembers, 4 years ago. And Northern Ireland are closing their men down very well indeed. The Algerians have not been given much space. Assad won't need an invitation either. It looks as though he's going to try and tee himself up. Then David McCreary took the ball away from him. Although he's given it away this time. Important for Ireland not to concede a goal in these closing moments of the first half. There's a first touch, I think, for Rashid Harkouk. Not a successful one. Jimmy Nicol. And another free kick going Northern Ireland's way. And, oh, there's a bit of hoo-ha going on there. And the referee, as I said a moment ago, is going to have to get strong here because there could be trouble for some of these players. Especially, I think, on the Algerian side at the moment, the way things are happening. The free kick had already been given to Northern Ireland and that was all rather unnecessary.
That was an astonishing incident, John. I felt quite convinced that the Algerian player came across and not dropped the Irish player, but certainly shoved him. I think the referee is going to have to take a very, very strong line indeed with these players.
The two Macs, McIlroy and McCreary, sorting things out. McIlroy eventually floating it towards the edge of the penalty area, and it's away as far as Harkouk, and now Cassie Saïd over the halfway line. And I think he got caught in two minds there. He wasn't sure whether to play the ball wide to the left. In the end, he played it straight to an Irish boot. And this time the referee's decision is in the favour of Algeria. So midway inside the Northern Ireland half. Again, the build-up slow and deliberate. And it's not often we've seen the ball out there on that left flank where Salah Assad is at the moment. And here is Assad. That was a better pass. Now he's got the chance to put in a telling cross here. Couldn't do so though. So they ask him to do it again and do a little better this time perhaps. Would you believe it? He's managed to find the same Irish defender. So, Penny. Very good player on the ball, Stephen Penny. He's done a good job for Brighton and Hove Albion. McDonald, and now O'Donoghue taking things up. Seems to have made a total recovery from that clash of heads that he had with Majer, who sadly has had to leave the field. And the Irish are moving around pretty nimbly, and McCreary has done well there, almost got into a shooting position, and there was a nice little bit of interplay then.
At times, both Sammy McIlroy and McCreary, David McCreary, have got in there, nice 1-2s.
But here's Assad, a thunderous left foot shot. It was way off the target in the end, but it just showed that Ireland mustn't be complacent. Assad is not only pacey, he's got a good shot on him as well. And he got round the back of the Irish defence that time.
He's very quick, John, and he's got a nice touch. I'm not entirely sure that he knows exactly when to deliver that final pass.
Northern Ireland 1, Algeria 0. Norman Whiteside, the goal scorer. So we're very much in the closing stages of this half. And here's David McCreary of Newcastle United. and he's going to win a free kick. Cassie Said almost grabs him by the throat. And the referee is now pushing Sammy McIlroy away as he was trying to get up. And it's all getting a little bit scruffy out there.
Yes, it's very untidy at the moment. The referee, it was an astonishing reaction by the referee. But he's really got to take a firm hand, because if he lets the Algerian players away with this type of action, then he's going to have serious consequences late in the match.
So again, El Labi tries to protect his goal and organise his defence. This time the ball has drifted aimlessly out for a throw-in. Zoran Petrovic of Yugoslavia gets his name on the screen because he's the Yugoslavian linesman there. Mejadi, one of several players who plays in France. He's with Monaco, a very, very good French club side. Well, he actually plays under a different name, would you believe, in France, Ligion. That's a good, useful ball. Haku trying to get round the back of McDonald, who defended very well there. And that, the most dangerous through ball we've seen in the match.
It was a good pass, but equally it was good defending by the big lad McDonald. Been a tremendous find for Northern Ireland.
Certainly has. When you think he only made his debut back in October, he's won his place well, and he's keeping John McClellan out of this side today. Pat Jennings just looking to see where the best option is. It's provided for him by Nigel Worthington, and sensibly now Northern Ireland slowing things down. You'll hear a half-time whistle very shortly. Although, of course, there has been a little bit of stoppage time in this first half, with the injury to Majer and Donaghy first of all, and then another injury shortly after that. And certainly one feels that Northern Ireland have reaped the benefits here of the altitude training. They've looked very fit and controlled in this first half, and able to handle all the conditions, and it's certainly very hot in Guadalajara. 45 minutes up on the clock. Important now for Northern Ireland, though, to keep their composure. These closing seconds, not give anything away. And there's danger here with Ben Marbrook, and that will be a corner kick. The referee signalling for the corner to be taken. And now it is of paramount importance that Northern Ireland don't concede something here. Assad taking the short one. Perhaps they're not aware of just how close the half-time whistle is. The referee just having a quick look at his watch there, deciding there's still time for something to happen in this half. And the cross to the far post will be too far for Maroc. Again, the referee looks at his watch. And again, he decides to let play continue. So a considerable amount of stoppage time being added on here. But indeed now, Mr. Butchenko does a blow for the end of the first half, and a very satisfactory half indeed for Northern Ireland.
The other match being played tonight, Mexico 2, Belgium 1. Let's go back now and rejoin our commentators in Guadalajara.
Right.
performance in the first half. They worked hard, they closed people down, they were positive. The goal was no more than they deserved. They possibly could have had a couple of more. Billy Hamilton's missed quite a good chance when Norman Whiteside put him through and the header off the line. But there have just been signs that the Algerians have started to come into the game. They've played a lot of possession people, and they've always got the possibility of midfield players like Cassie's side breaking through, as you've just seen there.
The first time really we've seen him breaking through with that kind of positive nature. He was the player that Billy Bingham had witnessed beforehand was likely to be the danger man for Northern Ireland, but he hasn't had the impact that they would have been hoping for. But that was certainly a very spirited run through and very nearly caught Northern Ireland cold. But Jardy's tackle then on David McCreary.
Thank you very much.
There's McCreary, and throughout the first half was perpetual motion, really. And one of the outstanding players, without a doubt, for Northern Ireland so far, David McCreary, a player who's used to the heat, I suppose. He had a couple of years with Telstra in the North American League, playing in the same kind of conditions that they've had to cope with here, as Worthington crosses in towards Penny. And Larby just did it. It'll be a corner anyway. But once again, a very positive break by Northern Ireland, Ron.
Yes, tremendous first down the left from Nigel Worthington. A good early ball to the near post. And Penny was extremely unlucky not to make contact with it.
So Penny will take the corner. Northern Ireland have sent McDonald forward there, central defender who's so dangerous on these set pieces, and one of the reasons that Bingham has included him in preference to John McClellan is the threat that he poses on corners and free kicks. Hamilton in there too, extremely high, but Hamilton climbed and couldn't direct his header with any real venom or direction. Billy Hamilton nearly a year out through injury, but he's battled his way back, and how bravely he's fought up front for Northern Ireland today.
Yes, both front players, Whiteside and Hamilton, have worked tremendously hard for the side. They've had a lot of running to do. Every time they've lost possession, the Irish midfield have just retreated to the halfway line and left it to Norman and Billy Hamilton just to delay, just to make sure that the Algerians don't get an early strike from the back line.
It'll flick off then from Assad, but here's McElroy, Penny. One of four players operating in a midfield quartet, really, for Northern Ireland. But Penny has had the opportunity to break forward, and he's taken it well on occasions. And here's McElroy, the Northern Ireland captain. McElroy, who thought long and hard about taking part in these finals here after the sad death of his mother. He flew back to England but was persuaded by his father to come out and play in his mother's memory. That's what she would have wanted.
A player that's had very little first of his experience this season. He's played exceptionally well. Skipper the side well, he's took responsibility. He's came and got the ball off the back players when needed, and he's gone out and just pressurised himself. He's worked hard at closing people down.
And it's certainly Billy Bingham's view that although he may not have played many matches for Manchester City this season, well, when he pulls on that Northern Ireland shirt, he's a new man. Penny with the cross, looking for McDonald and O'Neill at the far post. Collision of bodies, and what has the referee decided there? It's a throw to Algeria. And I remember that similar ploy, Ron, with the goal against Denmark when McDonald arrived at the far post with the cross in from Penny.
That's right, and also Billy Bingham has this theory that despite the size of the two centre-backs, reducing Carucci, that Ireland can well exploit them on high balls into the box. After all said and done, you know, your Ireland, they've got Big McDonald when he comes up, they've got Norman Whiteside, Billy Hamilton, John O'Neill. They're all more than useful players on big high balls into the box.
Carucci, and as Guendouz challenging with Hamilton. Carucci is certainly a big fellow at the back. He's 6'4", and there he is tackling. He's 13 stone as well. We're thinking of having a six-a-side match at the hotel next week, Ron, and he's going to be in my team, along with Gurka Chir of Spain.
Well, I'll take Whiteside as soon as.
Cassie Saeed. Sidali had made the run, and he was picked out well by
Kathy Saeed, and all Zidane just retrieved the ball. And again, McDonald came across. But a corner here then to Algeria, which Assad will take, and watch for Karouchi, the huge number four, who's lurking on the edge of the area. Oh, Rashid Harkout got his header in there. He came on as a substitute in the first half for Magier. He couldn't get his header on target.
No, I think you'll find you're talking about when Harkout came on for Magier. In that collision, Mel Donaghy split his header. It looks very much as if he and Worthington are going to share the left-back responsibilities. Donaghy's slotted into the position now, but they've been doing a little tandem job, switching over with each other. Occasionally Donaghy will push into midfield and Worthington will sit out at the back, and then vice versa.
Nigel Worthington has certainly done a solid job down that left flank. A player who's been out with injury towards the end of last season, and it had seemed at one stage doubtful that he would make the finals here in Mexico. But he's not only done that, he's got his base in the side, and along with all the Northern Ireland players today, has performed extremely well. It's been a sound team performance, capped by the goal after just 5 minutes from Norman Whiteside, the shot that flew in off the wall. Zidane. Assad going in, but beaten by O'Neill. And Hamilton scrapping away as ever with the free kick given to Algeria. Up goes Karouchi, take his position around the edge of the penalty area. And Hamilton once again has come back to mark him, out of the picture at the moment. Now, what will the Algerians try here? It was a free kick, remember, that produced the Northern Ireland goal, but from a position much closer to the penalty area. I don't think there's any doubt with the rarefied air here in Mexico that the free kicks are going to play an important role. Here's Harkouk, just right behind it. But a good effort then by Harkouk. Something of a surprise selection in the Algerian side. It was felt that Menat, their leading scorer from the qualifying games, would be in the starting lineup. And Harkouk preferred to him on the bench as well.
I think that in many ways is due to the fact that the manager probably feels he's got experience against English-type defenders. It was noticeable when he first came on, he was pushed right up into a central position. They started off the game without a central striker. And when Maggio went off, Harcourt came up and pushed himself right up against McDonald and O'Neill.
The Northern Ireland have come here 8 matches without defeat. That's quite a run. Indeed, you have to go right back to February of last year before their last defeat, and that was against England in Belfast. And only 2 goals conceded in that 8-game run. Whiteside's header. So competitive, Norman Whiteside. And the referee is waving play on as players contest that situation, and the outcome of it all is a throw to Northern Ireland. The feeling is that if either side should lose this game, they're going to find it very hard indeed to qualify for the next phase. Northern Ireland with Spain and Brazil still to play. Feeling from the first game, Brazil and Spain was, well, though Brazil played in the second half, there was nothing really to frighten Northern Ireland, and they certainly won't be overawed by the occasion when they play Brazil in their final match. And of course the memories will be flooding back from Valencia when they take on Spain on Saturday. Northern Ireland with that memorable win over Spain in Valencia in the last World Cup. And at the moment it's looking good for them here in their opening match against Algeria. Leading by a goal to nil, the goal scored by Norman Whiteside.
Yes, I think the biggest thing they've got to do now, Peter, is keep the concentration, keep the discipline.
They've got a good playing pattern. They're hitting the ball up to the front players early. You can just see there. Norman Whiteside has been put in there to hold the ball up to try and keep possession and let the midfield players get up and perhaps give them a breather at a time or two. I just wonder as the game progresses whether Billy Hamilton, who's worked terrifically hard but hasn't played a lot of football this season, I wonder whether he might be replaced by Colin Clark to do the same sort of job as Billy is doing so well at the moment. Billy Hamilton, who's been out for so long through injury, and once again we've got another caution here, haven't we? The referee's searching for his card, is he? I was just saying there about Billy Hamilton. Majadi there is the Algerian player. Billy Hamilton, who has had to battle his way back to fitness, and the feeling was that he might struggle for the entire 90 minutes. But he's such a valuable performer for Northern Ireland. Kasi Saeed with Assad. Free kick on the edge of the area. Kasi Saeed writhing in agony. Quite sure what the protest is from the Algerian players. They've got the free kick. Peter, we've just seen Harcock try to run one of these in and bring Jennings to his knees. I can recall a game he played against us for Notts County 2 or 3 years ago when he bent one of these round the edge of the wall. And Gary Bailey had to go the distance to make a hell of a save. And he may be with a third division club with Notts County, Harcock, but he's a very talented player. And the Algerians feel that he's now settled well into their style. Although, as I was saying earlier on, it was felt that Menad would be in the starting lineup, and Zidane with the shot! Zidane! A beautifully struck free kick by Zidane. That was a magnificent goal. Went clean through the wall there, Ron. Yes, both goals, the people have broke from out of the wall, and we always try and make it a rule that if you're in the wall, you stay put, you don't break. And I think both goals have come as a result of players breaking out of the wall. So there's a real test on now for Northern Ireland. Zidane has made it 1-1. About 13 minutes into the second half. Hamilton with the header on. Both goals then have come from free kicks. And Pat Jennings just simply couldn't get down to that one. It was gloriously hit by Zidane. A player we hadn't expected to be in their starting lineup. They gave us a rather different team yesterday to the one that finally arrived on the pitch. Which has been rather par for the course, I think, so far in Guadalajara. Things haven't quite worked out as planned. But we're pleased to say that I gather you're hearing us okay now in London and indeed all over the UK. Pat Jennings, the world's most capped player, beaten by the shot from Zidane. It's only, I think, what now, the second goal that's gone past Pat Jennings in 9 matches. The other one that they conceded was led in by Jim Platt in the second half against Morocco. Beloumi, the Algerian captain, who didn't make the starting lineup today, he's been struggling to recover fitness, is now warming up down on the touchline, so perhaps the Algerians are considering bringing him on now. But they're back in this game at 1-1. McDonald and O'Neill both stationed at the far post. Penny curling it in, he's been practicing those all week, and to some effect in the training program. Zidane, the goal scorer. Bit of a ringer we felt for Mickey Thomas, the Welsh international. And Zidane, who's opened this game up again now to make it 1-1. And I think, Rob, we're going to be in for a very interesting last half an hour.
I think so, because a draw really isn't too much use to either side. A draw would be a great result for Spain. If either side draws, it virtually means they've got to go and beat Brazil and Spain to have a chance of qualifying, and that's a tall task. I feel for the Irish a little bit, because I felt the free kick given against them on the edge of the box was a little bit harsh.
I thought it was an honest competition for the ball, and maybe the referee was a little bit overzealous there, but it certainly cost Ireland dearly.
It's been some very intriguing amateur dramatics from some of the Algerian players after one or two tackles. And that'll be a free kick to Northern Ireland. We now have Ian Stewart going through his paces down below us. Billy Bingham has often tended to play with two wingers, but on this occasion opting for just the one in Steve Penny, with Nigel Worthington operating down the left flank. More in a midfield role, or as Ron was saying, helping Mal Donaghy out on occasions too, with Hamilton here, finding now O'Neill. Up towards Whiteside. Gwendouz was higher though. Here's Donaghy. Trying the shot, came off Cassie Saeed, and a corner to Northern Ireland. And again, we'll look to the aerial threat posed by O'Neill and McDonald. O'Neill, remember, who had that header cleared off the line in the first half. It'll be Penny with the corner. Whiteside on the near post, but pulling away, and Larby has held on tight. Worthington. Kurucci to Ben Mabrouk. The goal will have given Algeria a lift after they'd suffered such an early setback with a goal from Whiteside. But here now then is Penny. Good tackle though by Gwendouz. Plenty of international experience. Gwendouz, 10 years in the Algerian national side. Most of these players play their club football abroad, including Harkouk, of course, in England. Rest mainly in France as Penny crosses it in. Nicol with the shot. Well, he's only scored the one goal for Northern Ireland, Jimmy Nicol. And I was delighted to be there that day when he scored against Sweden. That was back in 1980. The sweetly struck left foot, I remember, Ron.
That's right. I think one of the pleasing things from the Irish point of view is the fact that since Algeria have equalised, the Irish have picked their game up again. They've been a little bit inclined to play on the break, winning 1-0, I think a little bit content and conditioned to defending that 1-0 lead. Now they know they've got to come out and try and win the game. Stewart's warming up, so I wonder whether that's a sign that they're going to throw in an extra attacker.
Mejadi. This is O'Neill, now then to Jimmy Nicol, winning today his 71st cap for Northern Ireland. Nicol with the throw. Sammy McElroy. Finding Donaghy as the Irish switch the play down to their left flank. He has Worthington outside him. Alan McDonald. It's been a revelation since coming into the Northern Ireland side. Such an impressive debut against Romania. And my word, he played well too against England at Wembley. Once again, a little altercation involving Billy Hamilton, who's Russian, I don't think is too good. And Northern Ireland, I think, are indeed going to make a substitution with Ian Stewart coming on. Zidane. Good interception, though, by O'Neill. Assad. It's a lot more confidence about Algeria at the moment, as you'd expect, with a goal that's leveled this match at 1-1. Oh, Again, it's another huge clearance upfield by Pat Jennings. Now Donaghy. Didn't quite keep it in play, though. And Ian Stewart has now removed his tracksuit, just as I say that he puts it back on again. But it'll be interesting to see who does come off. Steve Penny is the recognised winger up there at the moment. But here's Harcourt now then for Algeria. Faced by Worthington. Now then for Mejadi. Kassis Saeed. Long and hopeful cross. And it is indeed Steve Penny who'll be replaced by Ian Stewart. We're halfway through indeed the second half. Ron, are we on the substitution now?
Yes, Penny's worked very, very hard up and down the right-hand side of the field. I just wonder where he's going to play Stewart, whether Stewart's going to stay. He's a left-sided player. I wonder whether he's in fact going to stay on the right-hand side of the field, just to keep the balance and the shape of the side. I think possibly that's no reflection on young Penny. I think what it is, Billy Bingham's probably said, all right, we'll have fresh legs. Stewart has done well in training. He's an unpredictable sort of a player, but he does have the ability when his game's right to go past people and produce the unexpected. I'm sure that's what the Irish manager's relying on at the moment.
Foul then on Norman Whiteside.
Carucci hasn't left Norman Whiteside's side in this stage of the game, second half of the match. I think he's probably got memories. You played against him in a club game. We played on a club tour against the Algerian national side some time ago, so he knows what to expect from the big fella.
Wellington with a shot that was charged down. You may or may not be able to hear the tremendous noise around the stadium at the moment, which was not a reflection on the match here, but on what's going on in Mexico's match. As Stewart bursts away. Hamilton in the middle. Stewart going on. And the shot off the legs of the goalkeeper. And Ian Stewart, having only just come on the field, had the opportunity there to restore Northern Ireland's lead. Decided to go alone rather than pick out Hamilton. And all he's got from it is the corner. She takes himself. Delicate chip in. Whistle's gone for a free kick.
That was a great situation for Northern Ireland, for Ian Stewart himself. He could have been the hero of all Ireland then. First touch, they tried to play offside the Algerian back four. Billy Hamilton was waiting for a little cutback from Ian Stewart. I think, to be fair, I think he elected to do the right thing to shoot. He was positive in that respect. Possibly he might have gone for the far stick.
But it goes down as an opportunity for Northern Ireland. And they haven't had too many of them. The goal, of course, of Whiteside, O'Neill's header, one for Hamilton. But that was certainly an opening for Ian Stewart.
It's funny how little things like that could give his side a lift as well, you know. At least they know now, as I said earlier, they've got to try and win it. They're pushing forward very, very positively. And at least if they see a situation where they can make chances against the Algerians, let's hope he gives them heart to go at them some more.
Belloumi, I think, will be joining the action fairly soon. One of the stars from 82. Belloumi, he's been recovering from a broken leg and one as well as serious injuries too. And we were led to believe that he was going to start the game, but he's only been on the bench. But I think he's going to be brought on any moment now. A very influential player in midfield. And it looks as if Zidane, the goal scorer, will be the man they'll be replacing. Here's Stewart, which Ron was saying has been very impressive in training. And it hasn't been easy for everyone to settle in quickly, and they've had problems indeed overnight with one of the Irish officials having the infamous Montezuma's revenge, which I gather is all down to a meringue pie. Carucci with a clearance. As Hamilton came in, Carucci has stayed down. He was caught by Hamilton. Again, I think he's rather making a meal of it, Ron.
Well, they get on my nerves a little bit, the Algerians, in that respect. Every time there's a physical challenge, they go down as if they've been poleaxed. then the next player goes in and tries to start pushing and shoving with the Irish players, and what they do, they get themselves in trouble, but they'll get the opposition players in trouble as well. Now Bellumi's coming on, and number 14 Zidane's coming off the goal scorer.
Rucci is still down on the ground. When I say he made a meal of it, let's hope it's not a meringue pie. Carucci certainly appears to be mortally wounded. On come the two trainers. We can see a lot of the bags of water being thrown on, Ron, and it was something we were talking to John McVeigh about, the Irishman yesterday, weren't we?
Yes, as in Madrid and in Spain in 82, they've decided to try and get as much liquid into the players as they can. I mean, before the game, they drink loads and loads of water. At half-time, they'll have the same to replace lost fluid, and this is what they're doing at the moment. More as a cooling-down thing, I must admit, and I think the Algerians could do with some of that at the moment.
Well, Carucci is back on his feet. And play resumes. With Northern Ireland in possession over on that far side then with Donaghy. McIlroy. Donaghy again. Algeria with all 10 outfield players back behind the ball. And there's no way through on this occasion for Northern Ireland. Keep ball from both sides. Bellumi on then for Zidane. Bellumi, who scored one of those two goals against West Germany in that famous win in Spain 4 years ago. Assad also featured prominently in that first phase. Now Maroc, here's Bellumi. Assad. And they swapped a few passes here, Algeria. Stewart away. But it's a cagey approach from both sides, just hoping to prize an opening. 1-1 here in Guadalajara. A crowd, we would think, around about 25,000. Which is certainly less than the 65 or so that watched the opening game, Brazil against Spain at the Jalisco Stadium. But a good atmosphere here, enhanced by the news that's coming through of Mexico's game, which is at times creating more interest for the crowd than the game going on in front of them. Which is rather a shame, because Northern Ireland can be proud of their performance. Although, as we were saying earlier on, this is the game they dearly need to win. Assad. Mansouri, but deception was by Jimmy Nicol. Assad again. Always looks very direct and positive, Assad, and he was held back there. So it's Northern Ireland's turn to defend a free kick. And they've pulled everybody back now. Bellumi is there directing operations with Maroc and Mansouri. And watch for Carucci, the big number four on the edge of the area. Here he is challenging now. Jennings underneath it. And Hamilton it was who once again come back to pick up Carucci. As Northern Ireland break away now then with Nigel Worthington.
Peter, this is the stage of the game where all that hard work in Albuquerque and all the hard running they've done since they've been in Guadalajara is going to pay, or will hopefully pay off for the Irish. For some talk amongst some of the leading German coaches that Algeria are probably the best prepared team in this sort of group, even better prepared than Spain and Brazil. But I can certainly vouch for the way the Irish boys have worked in training. They've worked tremendously hard, and there's an incident over there. Sammy McElwain is in trouble, I think. Sammy has just taken a kick. And is it Benbrook? He's in a lot of trouble here, I think.
And McIlroy has been booked. But again, it did appear that the Algerians were overreacting. the slightest sign of trouble, and down they go. But the name of Sammy McIlroy has been taken, and he's earned Northern Ireland's first yellow card of these finals here in Mexico. 1-1, 15 minutes or so to go. O'Neill is on the edge of the six-yard area. Here's Donaghy. Worthington, now can he get across it? Off Pelumi, and a corner to Northern Ireland. We're angry there that Lavi put the ball into the stands. Stewart has gone across then to take the corner. McDonald has come up. Hamilton in there too, and O'Neill. And Whiteside, the scorer of Northern Ireland's goal. Larby's come for it. He just managed to get a fist away. Bit of a surprise that he was in the starting lineup. We were told that Drid, their normal goalkeeper, would take the field today. But no, when the team sheet came round, El Larby was wearing the goalkeeper's jersey. In fact, we were talking, Ron, weren't we, to Rashid Harcook earlier in the week and asking him about some of the players. And when I asked him about the goalkeepers, he said, oh, I've nothing to say about them. So I don't think he had too much confidence in them.
No, and it, from a commentator's point of view, it's always a little bit dangerous to sort of say a goalkeeper can't do this and can't do that, because they invariably prove you wrong. But certainly, Larby hasn't looked, particularly in the early stages, he didn't look the most confident of keepers.
Getting a team out of the Algerians wasn't easy this week. And I had the problems too at the training camp, where Ron Atkinson was asked to leave on sitting on a wall watching the Algerian session. Did you see too much, Ron? I mean, it was about 5 minutes, didn't you?
That's right. Certainly, we were a little bit alarmed when we read reports that you and I had been thrown out by, what was it, pistol-packing policemen or something.
It wasn't quite as serious as was suggested, but the trainer did in fact stop the match until Ron had climbed down from the wall. Quite right too. Whiteside. But generally there have been problems with communications here, and not only during the match itself, but getting sound back to you in England. Problems on the telephone too. As Hamilton heads it down, Whiteside going in. I in fact endeavoured to make a transfer charge call to Birmingham the other morning, and when I got through, the person at the other end said, why are you phoning Burma? Yet another Algerian player goes down, and it's another booking for Norman Whiteside.
That's frustration, actually. I can't really understand why Norman, he did actually take a kick at the lead off the ball. That's frustration creeping in. They've been provoked a lot by things that have gone on off the ball by the Algerians. But this is the time when you remain sensible, keep your cool. And who knows, that booking might cost Norman a place in one of the latter matches if they go through.
Cassie Saeed, I think, is the Algerian player there.
Peter, this hasn't been a bad spell since the goal for Ireland. They've got themselves into a position where they look more likely winners. Just feel now that Billy Hamilton has done all he can for the side. He's worked hard, and it might just be time. I see that Colin Clark's warming up. There's 10 minutes left. Perhaps it's the time to throw him on now, the fresh legs we talked about, and just go for it.
There had been a suggestion beforehand that Colin Clark would start the game. Billy Bingham opted instead for a combination of Whiteside and Hamilton. Colin Clark, who may well be joining the Italian club Torino next season. I think that may well depend on how he performs here in Mexico, so you can imagine how anxious he'll be to get on for Northern Ireland today.
In actual fact, if you look round, there's a number of players that could be playing for fresh clubs next season, isn't there? Both Jimmy Nicol and Jerry Armstrong have been released by West Bromwich. We understand that Mal Donaghy and John O'Neill's contract are out of contract. Even Rashid Harcook, of course, could do himself a power of good if he had a good World Cup.
Who knows, if one or two of them do well out here, they might well end up at Old Trafford. Or Algeria. And it's Norman Whiteside, Ron, who's the player coming off. And I would think that has to do to a large extent with the fact that he has already been booked.
Yes, plus the fact, of course, Norman hasn't trained. Yesterday he trained for the first day for over a week. I wouldn't have brought him off if it's not for injury, because he's the player that looks as if he might create. Every time he's had the ball, to his feet. He's always looked as if he's going to create danger. But there has been this thing where, as I say, he's only really done about, what, 40 minutes training in the last week.
Shot coming in there from Nigel Worthington. Yes, Whiteside have been doubtful right up to this morning, really. Had the fitness test on the ankle and certainly had been thought at one stage that Clark would be playing in one of the two front positions. And there's news, isn't there, on that after the World Cup there'll be an operation pending for Norman Whiteside.
Yes, he's just going to have an exploratory operation on a knee that's been troubling him all season, and as soon as the World Cup's over he'll be going straight into hospital.
O'Neill bringing it away. Up there looking for Clark. And a free kick goes to Algeria. Humidity 60 here. 94 degrees the temperature. Not quite as hot as we thought, Ron, but it's still pretty warm out there. And the sun's even got through to me. My lily white legs have got a little bit of colour on them. And Ron is a ghastly shade of brown, as you can imagine. But that's down to the sunbed that he uses at Old Trafford as much as anything else. Bellumi is Harkouk. He's looked fairly lively since coming on in the first half for Magyar, which was a bitter blow for Algeria. Magyar, one of their top players, playing his club football for Porto. Indeed, he was voted the top foreign player in the Portuguese league last season, so you can imagine how much they're missing him today. But Harkouk has fared quite well, Ron.
He's played very well. I mean, he's the sort of player that you've always looked at and thought, what a good player he could be, maybe surrounded by good players. He's worked very hard, terrifically fit. What has surprised me about the side he's playing for at the moment is since they've got the equaliser, they've been quite happy, quite content to sit and just push the ball around, not push on. Now, we've said earlier, OK, they may consider it an honourable draw if that's how indeed it finishes, but I would have thought at this stage of the game, both sides have got to be looking to win it if they want to make progress in the second phase.
Less than 6 minutes, in fact, of the match now remaining. Can Northern Ireland pull this one out of the bag, or will they have to settle for a draw? They got off to such a promising start with that goal after only 5 minutes from Whiteside. And then the equaliser from Zidane. But Northern Ireland will be looking for a winner now in these last few minutes. And what a fillip it would be to go into the match against Spain with 2 points safely tucked away. Here's Clark. Worthington with the cross in. Hamilton challenging. Well, he made contact. Can he finish it off? Well, he's given, I think, the corner. But Hamilton so nearly got on the end of that one to turn it in. And we can see it again. And Hamilton couldn't direct it into the goal. But Stewart then with the corner. O'Neill has come up, and McDonald too. Stewart's cross, headed back by Hamilton. Only as far here as McElroy. And offside. As Ian Stewart turns the ball across.
That really is infuriating. They got the Algerians under a lot of pressure there. And Ian Stewart, who's the widest player on the field, looking along the line, goes and gets himself offside and breaks up a promising movement. Actually, that's twice he's done it. He did it a little bit earlier as well.
So here's Maroc then for Algeria. And they too won't be happy to settle for the draw. Bellumi to Majadi. Support arriving for Harkouk up front in the shape of Assad and Bellumi. But here now is Maroc. Mansouri. Less than 4 minutes left. Harkouk got the flick on. But safely through to Pat Jennings. Now, can Northern Ireland benefit from one of these long kicks which he was practicing yesterday to the extent that Billy Bingham was actually measuring how far they went? Hamilton, tackled though by Majadi. Here's Bellumi. Kassi Saeed. Looking so good for Northern Ireland in the first half. Now, at this stage, it looks as if they're going to have to share the points. Unless they can find a goal from somewhere in these remaining now 3 minutes. Gwendous. Can see Saeed. The game now almost at pedestrian pace. The heat taking its toll. The Algerians more used to playing in this kind of heat than the Northern Ireland players, although Sadani, the Algerian manager, was saying it's not quite as hot as you think where we are. We're not in the desert.
No, plus the fact there's an awful lot of them play in Europe. Rashid Harkov doesn't get too much sunshine in Nottingham, does he? What has surprised me about them is the way, okay, it's the way they play. They're patient, they knock the ball about. But really, at this stage, they've got to be looking for a winner. They've really, in the course of the game, had what? Two serious shots, one of which they've scored from. Ireland, on the other hand, have had themselves three or four good chances.
It's Marat back through. He's gone all the way, too. Cut out by Donaghy. And a corner to Algeria. So, Northern Ireland with some defending to do here. Clark and Hamilton have both come back. Bellumi. Carucci, a tall central defender, is waiting in the area. Bellumi, safely in the arms of the Northern Ireland goalkeeper, Pat Jennings. 41st birthday coming up in the match against Brazil. McCreary to McDonald. 2 minutes now left. McCreary to McIlroy. Now then for Jimmy Nicol. Here's Clark. And a marvellous season for Bournemouth. And how he dearly loved to score a goal here now that could be so crucial. Assad straight into O'Neill. Here's McCreary. Now Donaghy. Here's Hamilton. Stewart hadn't made the run that Hamilton was hoping for. Just over now, a minute to go.
Peter, I saw all the games in Spain that Ireland were involved in, and of course everybody remembers that night when they knocked the host nation out. But I'd have to say this, considering everything, considering the conditions, considering the amount of players that aren't playing recognised first team football, this for me is as good a performance as they gave in Spain. And I think, quite honestly, it'd be a bit unfair if they don't get away, if they don't win the game.
But if they do have to settle for the draw, I wonder what effect that will have with the games against Spain and Brazil still to come. And neither of those will be easy by any means. Ben Mabrouk for Algeria. They've come here in confident mood too. They feel they're good enough to qualify for the second phase. Kassi Saeed to Majadi. 30 seconds of normal time remaining. Here's Bellumi. It's 1-1 at the moment. Now then for Assad. Ben Mabrouk. Every Northern Ireland player now back in his own half. With just seconds remaining. Kassi Saeed. And it looks as if the Algerians are content then with the draw. And there indeed is the final whistle. And despite the encouragement of the goal after only 5 minutes from Norman Whiteside, the Northern Ireland side had to settle here for a draw. The goal from Zidane giving Algeria the equaliser in the second half. And Northern Ireland have drawn their opening match in Group D here in Guadalajara. It's Northern Ireland 1, Algeria 1, and we'll be back right after the break.
And Billy Hamilton will create a lot of problems for the...
Yes, indeed. The Russian referee we've just seen go through. Yes, indeed. And they will take a lot of heart from the fact that nobody gave them a great deal of chance in Spain, and they delighted and surprised a lot of people out there, of course.
Well, the one thing about us, Bran, we've always played with this great passion. We've always been short, as Bran has said quite rightly. We lack in certain skill factors and maybe the quality players, but the passion, the desire, the ambition, and every one of those lads playing tonight are playing for everybody back in Northern Ireland.
We'll run at them like we do, obviously, but I'm not sure if we can run at them for 90 minutes.
Right. That is the telling question, of course.
Like I say, Brian, I think it's important that these fellas, like I say, when you see Al McDonnell after the England game, he was talking about his brothers and his mother and his father, and I know exactly how they feel, because that's every match I played, I felt that way. You're representing people back home.
Yes.
And I'm sure everyone will be doing that.
There's our subs coming up. I'm sorry and disappointed young Campbell's not.
David Campbell of Nottingham Forest.
He can play anywhere.
Good player.
Play right back, midfield, up front, and he's a good sub.
And he's a good motor as well, Brian, hasn't he? He can work as well.
Well, we think he is, but I'm a little bit biased.
No, I think you're right.
But I'm not biased in giving an opinion.
No, I think you're dead
If he
right.
couldn't play, I'd tell you.
Oh, no, he's a good runner, he can work hard, and he's done well.
I'm surprised he's not on, particularly on his 21st.
Is it his 21st?
Aye.
Oh, dear.
He'll never get to 22 unless he looks up when to play a ball.
The big man looks very calm, Brian, doesn't he?
Well, he always does.
Yeah, he's very much in control of the whole situation.
All right, let's go across then to Guadalajara. I gather Peter Brackley is already underway with his commentary. Let's see if we can join him. Ron Atkinson is with him.
This is one today to qualify for the... Well, Ron Atkinson, sitting up on top of me here. What about the conditions out there? What about the problems the players are going to face? The crowd here at the stadium today would have been around. The Jalisco Stadium, but there's still quite a feeling about this one here, Ron. And a word on the Irish selection, in particular the choice at the back of McDonald in preference to McClellan.
And of course, one has to remember, Billy, that Norman Whiteside 4 years ago was the youngest man ever to play in World Cup finals.
Yes, it's astonishing to think that he's still only 21, and here he is, almost a veteran, as it were, of so many games for Manchester United. And indeed, this is his second World Cup. Tremendous record for a young player.
It's going to be interesting now to see how Algeria react to that early setback. And how nice to see Pat Jennings here. Pat Jennings, who will be 41 in 9 days' time. And how marvellous to think that he's virtually been out of the Football League all season. And here he is playing in a World Cup finals. His 117th cap. That's an international record for a goalkeeper. Now, the Algerians making those... late changes, and it's obviously a blow to them that Lakhdar Belloumi, a former African Footballer of the Year, is not starting the game. He is on the substitutes bench. And one or two surprises in the selection made by Rabah Sadani, their manager. But for now, all eyes are on Maldonahi. And the Irish, a goal to the good. Jimmy Nicol out on the right-hand touchline. Keen to impress in this World Cup, as he's been told that West Bromwich Albion will perhaps no longer require his services next season. Donaghy with the throw. And here's Sammy McIlroy, well-known
to my co-commentator here, Billy McNeil. He's his manager, of course, at Manchester City. And this time the Algerian defence is equal to it. There's some very experienced players in their defence. When you look at the number of caps that some of them have won, Mahmoud Gouindous, for example, 119 caps. Karichi has won 46 caps. And Cassie Said in midfield has a total of 86 caps, so you can see that there are some very experienced players in the Algerian side. There has been this surprise selection by their manager. Good pace there from Majer. Extraordinary that, the ball bouncing very high indeed and almost causing a problem for El Hadi Labi. Now Cassie Said,
well, Brian Clough has got a worry for them, Brian Hamilton, so it's almost edging 2-1 against Northern Ireland, which I must say surprises me. I would have thought that your lads might have been clear favourites tonight.
Well, I feel that the passion that the Irish have for the game and the desire they have to do well in this competition, and I think they, as I've said, look as if they're enjoying the whole competition, and I'm very confident and I expect us to win with a couple of clear goals.
I hope so, young man.
Thank you, sir.
Well, it's certainly the start of a very important time for Britain in this World Cup, with England playing later on tonight, and the team was announced last night, and Scotland playing tomorrow night against Denmark, which is another live game on our channel of the Irish lads there. It certainly looks as though it's another really hot occasion here in Guadalajara. It was 96 degrees the other afternoon. Of course, it's lunchtime, it's midday there in Guadalajara at the moment in Mexico. And the Algerians, Bruce, I suppose, would have a much better idea of how to adapt themselves to this sort of heat, wouldn't they?
That's correct. They play right up in the north of Africa, where the temperatures soar to 90 degrees in the winter. So they'll be very used to it.
In the winter?
That's in the winter, yes.
In 90 degrees in the winter? Degrees, yeah. Now, that's not bad. It gives them a fair start.
Now, just looking at that, Brian, yeah. I think one of the most important positions in the whole competition is going to be the goalkeeping position.
Well, I was just going to talk correct. About it. And 41 years old.
Well, I mean, people have their own ideas and the best in the world, and I've played with him and played against him, and I just think he's an incredible man, and I think he'll play a massive part in the Irish campaign this year.
Well, let's get another goalkeeper's view then of Pat Jennings. Bruce?
Pat is a marvellous example to any youngster who wanted to take up the sport. He's very dedicated, he works hard at his game, and he just loves playing, I think.
I think he's an example to anybody, anywhere, yes. Anytime.
That's right.
Sport doesn't come into it. We're just lucky to have him in our industry.
Mm-hmm. Well, the Algerian team caption coming up there, missing Rachid Harkouk, who we thought might well be playing, the Notts County man.
Why is he not playing, Brian? Is he injured?
No, I don't think he's injured. He's played three times for them, but he's obviously not been included on this occasion. And there we have the Northern Ireland team with the smiling Pat. And now, for the first time, you're looking at the complete rundown here. Jimmy Nicol, who'd had a little bit of trouble with injury, is fit to take the number two shirt. Mal Donaghy of Luton Town in the number three shirt, such a tremendous competitor. O'Neill, one of your lads from Leicester City, isn't he? MacDonald, big Alan MacDonald from Queen's Park Rangers. Little David McCreary, such a dynamo in the midfield. Now Penny, the right back from Brighton. Sammy McElroy, the skipper. And Big Norman at, wearing the number 10 shirt. Nigel Worthington from Sheffield Wednesday. And Billy Hamilton, who had such a terrible run with injuries. And it's good to see that the Oxford United lad has overcome those and now can get into the action.
Looking at that side, there's an awful lot of players in the team who can do a lot of work. McCreary, McElroy, Worthington, they can do a lot of legwork, and I think that that'll be an important asset tonight. I think you look at the two strikers, I'm a bit surprised to see Norman playing up there, but I can understand that he's strong, he knows the position, he can hold the ball up, and I think him...
Well, as you are well aware, you don't need me to tell you, I'm sure, we again, as we had, was it on Sunday night, terrible problems with our sound out of Guadalajara. Peter Brackley was the unfortunate commentator that night for Brazil and Spain, who didn't get a word uttered the whole of the 90 minutes, along with many, many commentators right through the world of television. And as you know, there were enormous repercussions between the European Broadcasting Union and FIFA over this, and it seems the problems are continuing. The Mexicans at the moment just seem unable to cope with the huge demands that are putting upon their communications. So, while the Russian referee looks to get the game started, at least it shouldn't spoil too much your enjoyment of it, I hope, because we can see that the Northern Ireland lads in the white shirts and green shorts are raring to go, and they'll be attacking the goal.
Atkinson, what do you think about Guadalajara just at the moment? So away then go Northern Ireland. This first ever international between the two nations. And Northern Ireland have certainly come here in good fettle, unbeaten in their last eight internationals. Indeed, the last time they were beaten was by England in Belfast, and that was as long ago as 15 months ago. Majadi, Majer, who will certainly be an important player for Algeria today. Majer, one of their overseas stars. It goes Donaghy now then for Northern Ireland.
In your mouth, please.
Tackle from Majadi. It'll be interesting, Ron, to see what formation the Algerians do use. It looks as if they're going to play with just two up front. Whiteside, good turn. The first shot of the game. Rather ambitious, perhaps, but Norman Whiteside showing confidence early on. And I think the Irish cap, Ron, will be most relieved that Norman is in the side. The Algerians, incidentally, have made a surprise in goal. El Labi has been chosen, contrary to reports that we've had throughout the week, Madrid would be their first choice goalkeeper, but they've made quite a few late changes at the last moment. And they've obviously got to compensate for the loss of Belloubi, one of their star players in midfield. This is John O'Neill. Long ball in search of Hamilton, who couldn't help jump there. Majadi. El Labi, who was certainly, we were told anyway, was the second choice goalkeeper. He's been referred today to Azredin Drid. Now this is Maroc for Algeria, one of their midfield players. Kassi Saeed, a player who's greatly impressed Billy Bingham. Matches that he's seen of Algeria, he saw their match in Switzerland recently. And Kassi Saeed is the player he's wanted to watch out for. This is Assad, one of the survivors from 82. He scored a couple of goals in their 3-2 win over Chile. Good tackle though by Donaghy. Plenty of support here for Northern Ireland in Guadalajara. Northern Ireland fans riding in the last few days. I think they can be sure of a good following here. Ferrucci, the defender who came across. Worthington with a throw, and here now that is Don.
Pendant TV London Weekend. Esta es la.
Sammy McElroy. McElroy and McCreary, the two players at the heart of the midfield for Northern Ireland today. Kenny and Worthington wide on the flanks. Looking to Kenny for some early crosses. The heading right side in Hamilton. Donald, the revelation he's been since coming into the Northern Ireland side, and his form has been such. Billy Bingham has kept it in today. Rather than bring back McClellan. Oh, back in the area there.
the ball hammered in from that free kick. It definitely took a deflection, but a really dream start for Billy Bingham's side, and you can see the looks of joy on the faces of the Irish players, Sammy McElroy and Norman Whiteside. And there the ball, it did cannon in off an Algerian defender. Norman Whiteside, though, takes the credit.
Yes, squished up from Northern Ireland. John, it's the ball straight through the middle of the lineup there. Bad lineup, but nevertheless, what's Algeria's misfortune is Northern Ireland's good fortune. It's a lovely start for them.
Well, Norman Whiteside scored three goals in the qualifying rounds, but that is perhaps the most crucial goal he's ever scored for his country.